Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. You guys are watching the Psychic Jyoti. In this video, we are going to see love in the general for the sign of Gemini. So watch this video if you're Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, or if you're dealing with one. Keep in mind, these are general readings, so it may or may not resonate. If it do not resonate, do not try to deliberately fit in. Check in any other placement, go watch Netflix, do whatever. Don't eat my head in the comments. Be like, why is this video not resonating with me? Bitch, because this is not your personal reading. All right. And if it resonates, then let me know how it did. If you want to have a personal reading with me, link is in the description. If you want to follow my Instagram, link is in the description. Also, a warning that I sometimes use bad words, so make sure that you have your earphones on while watching this video. All right, that's enough about it. Now let's see messages for a Gemini. If you don't already know, I'm a Gemini sun myself, so hey Gemini. All right, let's see week ahead messages for Gemini. Give me the present energy for Gemini, please. What is the present energy for Gemini? Nine of Cups. Ooh, wish fulfillment, Gemini. So Gemini, I feel that you feel very drained about the situation. So it's like you are hoping for something, you were manifesting something, but it is taking its own time. And now you're kind of losing your hope in the situation. You feel that this is never going to happen. You have been complaining and whining about the situation to universe. You're like, universe, don't you hear me? I want this, I want that. You haven't been delivering it to me, etc., etc. So something that you want is taking its own time, and that is kind of making you upset. But the good thing is that whatever you have hoped for is coming, is on its way, is going to reach to you very soon. So just hang in a little bit more. Don't lose hope, all right? As this one very beautiful quote that I read somewhere, and every time I break down or every time I feel hopeless, I just remind myself that quote, and it is, keep your faith higher than your fear, all right? So just, you have to keep your faith higher than your fear, Gemini. Wow, the Empress, Gemini, you are in manifestation mode is what I see. You are manifesting abundance. You are manifesting stability. Some of you are manifesting marriage, because Nine of Cups with the Empress is actually a marriage combination in tarot. So some of you have been hoping for a be all end all connection. Some of you feel that your friends are getting married, people in your family getting married and all of that. And you're kind of maybe losing hope. You're like, when is my turn going to come? When will I have stability? When will I have this money, or when will I have this business, or whatever you're manifesting is coming in. It's just taking a little more time, more than what you expected. And that could be because right now you are not the energetic match, or maybe universe wants to give you some more lessons before it delivers it to you. So just hang in a little bit more. But I see absolutely, absolutely beautiful energy curating here for you. I see abundance, I see wish fulfillment, I see your money growing. So yeah, it's beautiful. It's a beautiful energy here. You just need to maybe surrender. All right, just don't try to control everything. Don't try to overdo. Yeah, see, Queen of Swords. Just don't try to be bitter about all the situations, Gemini. And you know, being Gemini women or being Gemini, we people are like little bitter. You know, if like something does not go as per our plan, we can be the worst, the meanest people one could ever come across. Like, we just tap into that bitch mode very instantly. Gemini just tap into bitch mode like this. So some of you have been being a little bitchy these days. You're like, why is this not happening? Why is that not happening? Why is this person not behaving? Blah, 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 blah. So you just need to calm your tits a little bit. All right, Gemini? Yeah. All right, what else for Gemini? Give me some more present energy for Gemini. What is happening? For a while, Gemini. Gemini, are you getting married? Or are you manifesting marriage? This looks like marriage here, right off the bat. Right off the freaking bat, I see marriage on your cards, commitment on your cards, Gemini. But the only bad card here is Queen of Swords. And you know, Queen of Swords is your energy. So I see that you have been standing in your own way of manifestation, because you are becoming bitter about the delay. Don't become bitter about the delay. Trust that the universe is going to give it to you at the perfect time. You just need to hang in there a little bit more. Some of you might be buying a home, or you might be making investments somewhere. Your money, your abundance, your stability looks absolutely amazing. You know, I have been doing tarot readings here on YouTube for more than, I think, 3 years now or something about that. And I've never seen such a good combination right off the bat. Like in first line itself, we have three cards which shows absolute abundance. So this is, I think it's the best possible combination for you, Gemini. You just need to be a little more trusting. All right, don't lose hopes just because things are taking time. Things are going to happen in the most perfect way. When universe delays something, then it also compensates for it in a much bigger way. So just have that belief, all right? Okay, what else for Gemini? Three of Pentacles. Some of you, you're hoping for some sort of partnership maybe, or you're hoping to get some sort of help from someone. So you have been doing things all by yourself, but now you are seeking support. So this could be a career situation or your financial situation. I see you are going to get that with the Three of Pentacles. I see the most perfect person is going to come into your life who is going to help you. So just declare to universe that you want help and then sit back and see universe delivering it to you. And just when I was saying that sentence, I saw 555 on the timer of the video, which is confirming it. So yeah, the big change is going to happen. You just need to declare and then sit back and let universe deliver it to you. All right. And I definitely see some sort of partnership, both in your personal and professional life. I see people are going to help you. There is this perfect person that's going to come into your life. You are hoping for marriage with somebody. It's going to happen, Gemini. The Emperor. What better can happen here? We have the Emperor and the Empress both in the reading. Wow, this is so beautiful. Gemini, I feel that you had been manifesting marriage. You had been manifesting a commitment. And you were just hoping that universe makes you meet somebody who's like equal to you. Like you had been maybe you went through a separation in the recent past that literally blew you, you know, and you were like, why does this happen to me when I'm working so much on myself and I'm elevating myself? Why do I not attract people who are similar to me? And I see now is the time. So now you are attracting that perfect vibrational match for yourself because you have done a lot of work on yourself. I see abundance coming in. I see equal partnership coming in. I see a soulmate connection here right off the bat with the Emperor and the Empress and the Four of Wands. This is a very beautiful and empowering reading so far. So what is Gemini's feelings towards the situation Gemini is going through? You are being bitter about the delay is what I see, definitely. But what else? Yeah, Hierophant. And the Ace of Pentacles. That's what you feel. You're looking for a desperate change in your life is what I see. You have been feeling that you're doing so much. Why is the universe not giving it to you now? Or why is the delay happening again with the Ace of Pentacles and the Hierophant? You're quite dissatisfied because of the delay, but you're still very hopeful. That's a good thing. Though sometimes you become bitter, but still, you're not off the track. You still come back to the track. You come back to your work, which is good. And Gemini, I feel that you are now hoping for marriage. I don't know, marriage is on your mind. I see a lot. Commitment is on your mind. You feel that you have wasted a lot of time on so much of time on so many, immature people. And now you deserve a commitment. Now you deserve an equal partnership. That is what you are feeling. But see, Gemini, you are not seeing what universe is, curating for you. That is why you are just feeling a little bitter about it. So whatever you have been hoping for, a commitment, a stable connection, universe is exactly giving it to you with a little bit of delay because you need to learn a lesson or you have to just wait for the perfect divine timing. All right. You have been getting tired of the situation is what I see. Like you're just waiting for happiness to come into your life. You're like, when is this happiness going to come into my life? I have been manifesting. I have been doing everything. When my wish will be granted? Your wish is going to be granted very soon, sooner than you think. But you just need to hang in there a little bit more. Little bit, all right? Don't give up. Just before you hit the jackpot, don't give up. Okay, so what happened in the recent past with Gemini, please? What happened in the recent past with Gemini? Knight of Swords. Some of you feel that you were in a situation which was maybe a one-night stand or somebody just was very inconsistent. You were dealing with somebody who would just come and leave as they pleased. That kind of made you very, non-believing in love. So you feel that people are just fuckboys and fuckgirls and nobody's loyal and whatever. So it's like some of you, the obstacle is that it's like you are manifesting commitment, you are manifesting marriage, but deep down you have been hurt in the past and you're just carrying the same baggage in your present situation as well. So you haven't let go of your beliefs that everybody is a cheater. You feel deep down, you feel everybody is a cheater. So it is very difficult for you to trust somebody again. And that is kind of blocking your manifestation. That is blocking you from reaching where you want to go. So Gemini, just work on your belief systems. Maybe try to do journaling so that it gives you a clear picture, all right? You are standing in your own way is what I see. Something just happened in your past which kind of shook you, you know? Seven of Cups. See, yeah, I see in the past you had been dealing with narcissistic fuckboys and fuckgirls, people who never chose you, people who always took advantage of you. You were dealing with somebody who was having many other options going on and you kind of knew about it. So now, though you are manifesting all of this, but you can't even believe that something like this can happen, and that is why it's not happening, Gemini. So deep down you want a commitment, but then you feel that nobody will give you ever commitment because in your past you never got commitment, you know? So see, just when I said that, 11:11 on the timer. I just noticed these angel numbers so much. So yeah, that's the problem. That's the exact problem, Gemini. Because you have been hurt so much in the past, it is very difficult for you to trust all over again. Like this person, I see they took advantage of you, or they just played games with you and they were not giving you commitment. And it kind of pushed you to a limit where you had no other option rather than just choosing yourself and moving on. So yeah, somebody just pushed you to a limit where you had to completely give up on them and choose yourself, your self-respect, and move on. The good thing is that you have done it very wonderfully. So yeah, you moved on from that. You built up, you are building on yourself, you are doing good in your life, but then that hurt still bothers you. So that's the only problem. What's the present energy for Gemini towards the situation? Ten of Wands, you have been working very, very hard in your life. Some of you, you have been working on your goals, you're very focused, laser focused, doing a lot these days. Some of you just try to take some breaks. You're overburdening yourself. So good thing is that you're focusing on yourself, but the bad thing is that you're overburdening yourself. You don't have to overburden yourself, all right? With the Seven of Pentacles again, I see. Gemini, I keep on seeing this over and over again, that you have been working on a situation and you are waiting for results, but the results are getting delayed and you are frustrated. And now you feel that, will this ever happen or let me just move on? So your message is that it is going to happen exactly like you want or better than what you have anticipated. Just you need to hang in there a little bit and also try to take breaks. You know, when you are tired, you don't give up, you take breaks, all right? The World card. See, a new cycle is about to begin for you. Gemini, I also see that when you will feel that, okay, like I'm going to give up on this and this is never going to happen, that's when universe is going to show it to you that, yep, honey, here it is, your new beginning. So yeah, it is going to happen very unexpectedly. The World card is the beginning of a new cycle, but very unexpectedly. So the tables are going to turn. They are already almost on the verge of turning, but maybe universe is just trying to test you a little bit as to see if you will hang in there or will you give up. So yeah, universe is putting you a test. Just make sure that you prove to universe that you are not going to give up. All right. So let's see, what is this person's feelings towards Gemini that Gemini was dealing with? Ten of Cups. Now this person is valuing you. I see this person might be observing you because I saw the Page of Sword, but I see this person is also looking forward to what kind of stability they could have had with you. So somebody is missing you, the good times with you, and now they are realizing that you were the husband or the wife material. And they totally fucked the situation. They thought that they will just have one night stand with you and get away. But now they realize that you were the husband or the wife material they should not have messed up with. Somebody is realizing your worth now. This person is trying to come towards you, but they're going to do it very slowly is what I see. Someone keeps tabs on you. And they just want to offer you something which you least expect, because you anyway are not expecting much out of this person. You are just focusing on your own growth. And I see you will be running into someone who's very stable and equal match. However, your past person, they just look at you on social media or they just talk about you from some other people and they realize that they kind of messed up the situation with you. Somebody is just seeing that you are in a very victorious situation, like you are winning, you are doing good, you are getting the recognition and they watch you. So yeah, a new cycle will begin, Gemini, but it's going to happen very unexpectedly. Eight of Wands is again. So things are going to happen very unexpectedly. Make sure that you don't give up. Some of you will be tempted to give up. Don't give up. That's your message. And I see a communication coming in from someone who has hurt you a lot in the past. But I see this person now realizes what they missed with you and how you were so good. But you don't care because you have leveled up so much that you are going to move towards this stable person that's coming towards you. You being an empress, you will run into an emperor, or you being an emperor, you will run into an empress. Which is good. Some of you have two options. Or maybe this past person might be coming as an emperor, I don't know. Or you have two options. I very strongly feel you have two options. You will be choosing between a past person or a new person. Star card. Beautiful. Wish fulfillment, Gemini. Wish fulfillment. I see good times ahead. I see you are going to get the recognition. I see that universe is granting your wishes, but repeat after me. I am not going to give up and I'm going to wait in there. Alright? You have to do that. Do not give up just before you hit the jackpot. Over and over again, I'm telling this to you, Gemini. Something is definitely coming towards you and I see a very beautiful connection, a wish fulfillment, exactly what you wanted. You had been manifesting this, but universe is just trying to see if you will give up or you will hang in there. So show some patience. Unexpectedly, things are going to become very beautiful for you. Any other advice with Gemini? Devil card. I see you will be tempted to go into some sort of distraction or repeat a past mistake. Maybe give this person, this fuckboy or fuckgirl, a second chance. Make sure that you don't do that, Gemini. All right? If you have left something or someone behind, a situation behind or a toxic person behind, always remember why you did that in the first place. Because I see you are attracting very beautiful times ahead, but there will be like a codependent part of you that wants to go back to this toxic person who was a ghost, who lied to you, who betrayed to you. Make sure you just make a wise choice because you will be asked to make a choice very soon. And also work on your own limiting beliefs. As I said, like you are manifesting love, but deep down you don't believe that this can happen. So that is why it's not happening. When you will be open to love completely, that's when universe is going to give it to you. And I see this past person coming back to you. They had been playing mind games. They will be doing the same to you again. So be very careful. See, again, the two of wands, just when I said that. You will be having a choice and you have choice between two people. Some of you three people, because fool card is also here. So fool can be literally you having many options. So you can choose, but at least two people, Gemini. So you have an option to choose between two people and just make sure that you choose the best one, all right? Because your past toxic person will also try to come back to you. So make a wise choice. Give me a message for Gemini, please. Wedding. Oh my God, didn't I tell you this? Some of you, you're very close to getting married, Gemini. You're about to meet the one or you are about to get married. There is wedding involved. I was telling you, like, this was exactly my message here, right? Wedding is on cards. Wedding is on cards. You will be meeting the one you are supposed to be with. I say wedding. Wow, this is all beautiful. And this situation is just asking you to have trust. Again, the same message. Don't try to be bitter over the situation. If universe is taking time, it's going to bless you with something much more bigger than what you expected and how you expected. This is beautiful. So beautiful. Give me a message with Gemini. Hold your vision. Same thing. Don't give up. Don't give up just before you hit the jackpot. Hold your vision. You are on the right track. Your manifestations are being answered. Just hang in there a little bit. So yeah, that was a very beautiful reading. Hope this helps and resonate. If it does, make sure you subscribe, like, share, comment. I will see you very soon in the next video. Till then, you guys take care. Stay safe. Bye.